This week our search for talented pets has taken us to a pub called the Red Lion at Caythorpe in Lincolnshire, because you know all these campaigns to bring back real ale. But we've heard of a drinker with an even more discriminating palate. He belongs to Molly Burkett, and Glyn went to the bar to meet them, where the landlord pulled him various kinds of pints of beer, and they conducted an expert consumer test. His name is Jack.
He loves his beer. I think it's the yeast in it, to be quite honest, that crows find attractive. All crows like beer, a lot of animals do. But, you know, we don't let him have too much. We're a bit careful with him. But it doesn't take much beer for him to get fighting mad. Not really drunk, but, you know, a bit tipsy.
Seems to be having a wonderful time here, and we'll see which of these beers he likes best. How about a bit of draft Guinness? No draft Guinness? Well, what else can we try? Yes, we know you like that. Now try this one. Mild. Ah, not too bad. Yes, that's fine. Well, you've grown a taste for that. How about this? This is lager. Oh, yes, that's very nice. Now, this is the test. This is real ale. I said, that's real ale. You have to do better than that. It certainly seems to like lager rather than real ale today.
Well, to be quite honest, I don't think we've ever given him lager before. I haven't, you know, so perhaps that's his next acquired taste, I don't know.
Well, I think lager is definitely the winner. Now what are you going to do?
It's only just this last year that he's been so fussy about what sort of beer he has.
What are the long-term effects of this drinking on him?
We've had him more than 17 years and it doesn't seem to have affected him at all.
What is the life expectancy of a drunken crow?
I think we've got to find that out. He was a problem though when we had him flying free. Of course, his idea was to get to the nearest pub.
Ah, oh, there you are.
I think he prefers mine to his own.
I think he does. Yes.
I think we've got to the stage where you can't discriminate between one and another.
Now look what you've done.
Time, gentlemen, please.